The bleach drought, it is real. Let's be honest with you, there's been no news and everybody has resorted to either bot tweets or making up news or holding on to the very lit list of live streams ever just to get a sniff at a release date or whatever else they can get their hands on. And with other series getting some pretty big announcements, I can understand that the Bleach community, for one, is pretty frustrated. So let's talk about what we know and what we don't know within this video. Let's get into it, shall we? So before I talk about a possible release date, I want to talk about the things that we have and haven't got. For starters off, I made a tweet a while ago talking about Bleach coming back within the summer of this year. If you guys haven't noticed, it pretty much is drawing close to being the summer and we haven't had an announcement. But in the interim of all of this, we've had many announcements such as the Bleach musical, the Yokohama Tower, the Cafe of the April Fools event, and the review event at the Bandai Namco kind of building thing in Ikebukuro Sunshine City, which is really cool, by the way. But it's just a little booth of something with some cardboard cutouts and whatnot. It's just there and it's nice, but it's nothing too much to write home about. In fact, the food that they were selling was actually just really nice and probably the main attraction of it all. But I digress. It is nice nonetheless for Bandai to do something like that. Now, you can take this in two possible outcomes from a business perspective. Are these events being made to mitigate for a potential delay for what Bleach was supposed to be airing, but it isn't airing, so they're doing these events to kind of mitigate and do some sort of relevancy promotion? Or were these events made for a lead up for Bleach to come out in summer? But you have two perspectives, and either or, depending on what your perspective is, could be the correct answer. Either or, it's nice regardless, whether it was build up or whether it was mitigation. Who truly knows? But I will say, I just want to briefly touch upon these things before I get into the nitty-gritties of it, and then also talk about the Bleach games. But first, I just want to get these out the way because I thought they were really cool personally. First and foremost, the Bleach Rock musical being the beginning, starting off the Aranka arc. I personally went. It was about, what, £70, which would be more in dollars per ticket, and I went on the second to last day, and it was a packed house. I had the S seat, which is like a seat that's really close to the stage, and every seat was packed. All the booths at the top were absolutely packed, and again, it was the second to last day. So if you give that number of tickets compared to maybe how much the rent was for that theater as a whole, plus the paying of actors, I would say that it costs a lot to probably hire a place like that. But with the amount that the tickets cost and being a full house most probably every single day, as I went on a weekday, not even a weekend, it was very impressive to say the least. And all the tickets were sold out, and that's why I went the day that I went, because the tickets were sold out. So it was a very, very successful event, and it was a truly an amazing experience when it came to the effects, when it came to the CG, when it came to the actors, when it came to the costumes, the music. It was such a surreal experience, and it felt very 4D. And what I mean by that is that they didn't just use the stage, they used the walkways, they used behind, they went everywhere that the theater offered, and it was really close to just be sitting right next to some of the people, because I was on an aisle seat, so I was like sitting right next to Chad, and Chad gave me the look, and Ichigo gave me the look, and it was gas. It was pretty peak. And Orihime was like the star of the show. She was cute and singing the If I Lived Five Lives, I Would Still Love You. That, I mean, I didn't understand it, but like I knew that was the song because it was that scene, and it was just, ah, it was beautiful. And my girlfriend, who hadn't even really watched Bleach besides the live action movie, really enjoyed it and was like, when is the next one? And thankfully, it did so well that they announced it right after the Osaka show, and it's going to be called Bleach the Rock Musical The Final. So I think that just speaks volumes about how successful it did and how much of a, you know, that there's a supply and demand for it. So big up that, very excited, and I get it now. With live actions, I actually get it now, right? Some of you guys that live in the West, I get it. You'd be frustrated. You're like, oh, it's a musical. Like, what a shit announcement. I get it now. I really do. It makes money, and it's great for merchandise, and there's so many women there as well, which are just buying merchandise after merchandise. So it makes sense on a business thing. The Yokohama Tower, it's just an observatory. They had some bleach things in there, such as the manga, such as t-shirts, some cool little things like Soifan, like doing a Jakuhorai Kuban right at Yokohama City on like the glass. And it's little cool things like that. Again, it's nothing to write home about, but it was a nice little day out. Something that I'll put some pictures on the screen. You get to see some like little like how these scenes were made, such as Shinji's Bankai. You get to see some great key visual art, the hand-drawn art, especially my favorite being Ichigo's face that you again I see it on screen. So again, the event overall was amazing, and of course the cafe as well was over the Yokohama kind of, not, it wasn't a theme park, I guess it was a theme park. It had like this big wheel. It was nice. The food was nice, the theme was nice. Very good day out, and again, people were there, people were buying this food, they were buying the merch. And for an event that they made from an April Fool's Day of like the high school blood warfare, it's very limited to make merchandise off 4 images, but they did it and people were buying it. So I mean, all to them. I personally didn't buy anything, but all to them. So big stuff. And again, the Bandai review event, 2 people were there, and you know, all these things were success fundamentally. Now, before we get onto the anime news, I want to talk about games. Dragon Ball Tenkaichi 4 or Sparkling Meteor is doing numbers right now, and obviously I think it's probably a good thing that a Bleach game isn't happening right this minute, because all the attention is on Dragon Ball. Now, there is a little bit of frustration. We have waited ages for a game. I'm not talking about BBS, I'm not talking about Soul Resonance, and we'll talk about Soul Resonance as well, but you know, we know that there's an IP pattern. We know that it's called Rebirth of Souls. We understand this. We don't know what it is, or what it, if it's going to be console, whether it's going to be mobile game. We don't really know. It's probably going to be console, let's be honest, and we don't know when this is going to be truly announced. I said years ago that there was a game in the works, but again, when we actually see something is when we'll actually see something. But I understand the fans' frustration, the absolute drought that the Bleach fandom have when it comes to having all these things such as Dragon Ball. The Dragon Ball community is always, always, always eating, regardless of what. But then you have things such as like Kaiju 8, a series that literally just came out and already has a game going. It is frustrating. It is annoying. The Bleach fans are just wanting their time to be able to play something in between cores to keep the story alive, to get people involved in the story too, because most people are gonna, you know, get into a Bleach game through, you know, the Bleach story through a game. Many people get into anime games through the story of video games. So I feel like Bleach needs that, and it needs, you know, regardless of what type of game, I'm not going to get into that discussion, we'll talk about it when that time comes. It will happen, but the long wait is something that is frustrating. And truly, we should have had Bleach Soul Resonance extremely, extremely soon. I can't say the original date. I don't know what I'm allowed to say, because again, so many confusing things with ByteDance and a new verse and whatnot, whether the game is, you know, whatever, right? I know the original release date, and we were gonna have it extremely soon. Very, very soon. It was going to be in our hands, and there was probably going to be promotion up the wazoo currently. Now, is Bleach Soul Resonance still coming out? Yes. Is it coming out in 2024? As far as we know, yes, it's still coming out this year, and we should be hearing something, I would imagine, in the next month or so. I would imagine so. Communication has been very limited. I have not that much in terms of what's going on. I've heard good things, of course, but you have to just take it as it is, because I truly don't know the ins and outs. The game is strong, and I can't wait for people to play it, and I think people are really going to enjoy it, and I will still be continuing to advertise the game whether the team want to involve me or not. But I do think it is a quality product from what I played and from what I experienced, and all I can say is that it is going to be, as far as I know, coming out this year still, which is cool, right? Now, to get onto the other thing of, like, the anime. When's it coming out? Well, I can say that on the 7th of July, we're going to be getting a rebroadcasting of the Best Bouts, which we've already had that, but we're having it again, and maybe it's going to be different. I don't, again, know the ins and outs of things. As I said in my leak, that Bleach was supposed to come out in summer, and I guess we are getting Bleach in summer, but it's a rebroadcast, and then that kind of proves to me, especially when they're using a midnight time slot, that kind of proves to me that it was initially going to be in summer, but of course the delays did happen and they've got this time slot that they need to fill, and thus Bleach is now having a time slot through a rebroadcasting of some episodes, whether it be old Bleach or new Bleach, I'm not quite sure, but that is what's going on in July. And usually with July, you're gonna have the advertisements in between probably shilling the next core being core 3. So whether it's going to be in fall, whether it's going to be in 2025, we don't know. And the reason why I say this is because currently you might see an image, you might see a leak going around of like Bleach, the rivalry being in 2024. Again, there's been no announcement of a change, so things are going to still say 2024, or it still could be a placeholder. This is very common as well. I do think that it will be 2024. I do. It's also possible for 2025, but I'm personally more leaning towards 2024. I think go for 2025 winter, you know, just really, if you got the opportunity to delay it and put more quality, I say do it. But as far as I know, it is still possible for fall. I think, you know, the delay, to have two delays would be a bit crazy, but I think, yeah, I think it's going to be 2024, I think. Or they could just be, again, it's not unheard of to have promotion two seasons before an anime is released. So again, we'll just have to wait and see. But as far as we know, in terms of extra content, we're going to have some Akon and Nemu scenes that's going to be kind of added on. So the baby hold your hand, as far as I can guess, if we're going to have Akon and Nemu scenes, we're going to get to baby hold your hand, which was what, volume, was it 69? No. Was it? No, that's not right. Was it? No, 69 is Basby and Hoshwalt, and 71 is Baby Hold Your Hand. And it's confusing in terms of the timeline, because Kubo's daily posts was talking about Akon and Nemu, and then later on he talked about the dubbing for Basby and Hoshwalt. So whether they have correlation, whether they're dubbing within chronological order, that's another question. We'll have to wait and see. But we know we're going to get some extra content. This was always going to be known, and I genuinely cannot wait, because again, Akon love. I love Akon as a character. I love Nemu as a character. We need more emotional. Of course, it's going to be, you know, extra content with Mayuri, because Kubo loves Mayuri, X, Y, and Z. So yeah. And Hoshwalt and Basby, I think, is going to be a big moment as well. So probably on the second side of that core, you know. So in regards to everything that's happening, there is a massive Bleach drought. There is no denying that. And we're seeing a lot of series eat yet again from us. Now, I personally have my own little gripe, which is, you know, a lot of Bleach news could be on pause because Viz wants to also do announcements for Anime Expo or whatever. So like Viz could also be a part of the problem while we aren't getting announcements as quick as we can, because Viz want to be, you know, getting their money's worth, I guess, even though they don't do fuck all. But besides that, my personal bias aside, there is a massive Bleach drought, and maybe not in Japan, because obviously I do see Bleach stuff in Japan, again, with the broadcasting and all these events, like, I get that, but as a global thing, we got no games, we got no events, we got no news, we got nothing to keep us going, and I understand why everyone is so frustrated. And then to have things such as Kaiju 8 get a game out of nowhere, whether that is for good or bad reason, I don't know. You know, for example, after the first season of Berserk 2016, you had the game The Band of the Hawk, right? You get a new My Hero game and movie every year. Well, I don't think My Hero had a game this year, but it's still getting a new movie, right? You're having all these things with all these shows, and we're just kind of sitting there going like, Bleach has come back after 10 years, what's kicking off, right? And then you had the recent live stream with Nikkei talking about Taguchi being changed from director to like chief director, which again, I personally don't understand it to its full degree. I'm waiting for an official kind of announcement rather than like a translation diff announcement from that live stream. But as far as I know, it is a good thing. It is, in fact, a really desirable thing to have multiple directors and then have a chief director such as Taguchi. For example, Black Clover did the same thing towards around the time skip, right, where It was Yoshihara was the director for a long time, and then he moved to chief director, and then it was some series directors that then moved to directors, and it flowed better. The team were a bit more organized and efficient, and you saw Black Clover's time skip really improve a lot. So, you know, it's a good thing as far as we know, as far as desirability within a production, and again with Pierro Films and them trying to incentivize more young animators to join in, I think is a good move. So we can only wait, and I understand that many people are going to be very frustrated and anxious because we don't know what Pierro Films is, we don't know the extent of it, we don't know the priority of it, we don't know the increase of budget or efficiency or scheduling or time, we don't know any of this, we're going in completely blind in this situation. So I just kind of wanted to touch upon it, and there's many reasons why I haven't done videos about it, because I feel like there's not really anything to talk about as of interest. So, in terms of 2024, we have potentially a core three to look forward to, which I think is very, very plausible. I'm more on the 70% mark. I don't truly know. I'm asking around every day to get a confirmation. Once I get that confirmation, I'll make that video. And we know that so far as well, as far as I'm aware, that we're going to get Soul Resonance. So, we've still got some promotion. We've still got the anime and a game to come. And then hopefully, after all is said and done, we're going to probably go into 2025 talking about Core 4, what this means for the future of Bleach, and possibly a Bleach game. I don't like that it took this long to potentially get a console game for Bleach, but at the end of the day, with Tenkaichi 4 coming out, or Sparkling Meteor, maybe it was probably a good idea to maybe push that date back. That being said, tell me what you guys want in the comment section down below, and any thoughts that you have on my comments. With that being said, I'm going to catch you, motherfuckers, that you guys, of course, have this Friday. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.